The great tragedy today is women have become too much like men in their energy. Have you noticed that? Women are suffering deeply without knowing why. I have seen that in my entourage, beloved, because of so many thousands of years of patriarchal society that was dominated. So many tribes and for thousands and thousands of years with that male, divine masculine, not male at all, masculine energy of that mindset. And that has affected our planet for so many thousands of years with the conditioning of the patriarchal society, like dominated with dominion, conquest, destruction. See, beloved, throughout history, what has occurred on our planet. So even the masses have become really out of balance, but especially women in particularly in today's era. And in this video, Devi Mayi is going to demystify what is divine feminine energy and what is divine masculine energy, which transcend all gender, is beyond gender. So don't think that the divine masculine energy is not useful. Both are necessary for our planet, but because of what have occurred for too many thousands of years, most people have become out of balance. But like I said, women in particular, because of our era that we live in today, women tend to become very competitive and they start embodying a lot of the quality and values of the divine masculine energy. And they suffer. So we will demystify the two, what are the quality and what needs to be done for really becoming in balance and feel empowered with both energy, because ultimately, regardless of your gender, we all have the divine masculine and the divine feminine energy within our own being. And I will be talking about the ultimate harmonic marriage. We'll touch upon that in Kundalini Ascension, and as well as give three tips. Actually, they're not tips, they're yogic tools for you to be empowered, that you can start right now working on your divine feminine energy to really become aware of what's lacking in you. Okay, beloved? So we'll get started. Now stay tuned because it's going to be very empowering for you. So divine feminine energy, Shakti, only means power in the yogic tradition, the primordial energy of the cosmos. Shakti is just a name. It's not an embodiment of a female, very important to understand, is the primordial cosmic energy of the universe, which manifests, Shakti manifests everything. And we all have it within us, as I said, regardless of our gender. And masculine, divine masculine energy is the opposite. There are two opposite poles which are necessary to bring about the manifestation of existence, of the universe, of the cosmos. And they both have very different quality. They're opposite quality. And Shakti manifests as a primordial cosmic energy. And what we say in the yogic tradition, Shiva, that which that is not consciousness, it still is pure. When the two merges, they manifest this existence. I won't go into all the details because all of this is a lot, and it's all in Becoming the Light Inner Journey Mastery Program. And in Raiding the Light, we touch on the subject. But just to give you an overview of the yogic tradition, how we perceive the phenomenon in the universe. And remember, beloved, the macroscopic reflect you microscopic. What's happening out in the universe is happening within you being. So it's like yin and yang. You could look at it that way. When the marriage of the two is the ultimate marriage, the ultimate union within yourself. So when you are on the spiritual path, it's basically the journeys from the Muladhara to the Swahasara as the energy move. You see, beloved? And then when Shakti meets Shiva, this is where primordial energy and consciousness, pure consciousness, just merges. It happened within our own being. I can tell you from my own experience with my own Kundalini Ascension, which I talk in my programs in depth, because having spontaneous Kriya, speaking in tongues, and having all kind of mystical experiences, it's just purification. When Shakti comes and purifies what needs to be purified, you will see that some male are more in touch with their divine feminine energy, some of them. But generally speaking, most of them are more in touch with their masculine, divine masculine. Women in particular, we have a tendency to be more in touch with the divine feminine energy because, not because of the gender, but the fact that we have a womb and we create and we bring life into this world. I feel like from my own experience and from the yogic tradition, we're more sensitive, more receptive to it. And however, because of the patriarchal society dominating for so long, with that divine masculine mindset, has really influenced and conditioned women. You see, if you look at your life, you will notice. So let's look at what are the quality of divine feminine energy, creativity, manifesting beauty, unconditional love, nurturing, caring, compromising, spiritual union, and embracing everyone as yourself, as you evolve. All of this are beautiful quality, necessary. And the divine masculine energy is the opposite. Conquest, dominion, aggressiveness, physical prowess. You see what I'm saying? Just think of the opposite, which serve a higher purpose for the manifestation of this existence. Both are needed, but they need to be in balance. And that's what has occurred over so many thousands of years, is Mother Earth is out of balance. We need to bring back the divine feminine energy, not only on our planet, but within us, because it can only happen within us. And if you look back thousands and thousands of years, our matriarchal society who embodied those qualities were really thriving. And so write down in the comment below, what is you feel like is the most predominant divine energy within yourself? And I have seen it over and over in my entourage. So many women suffer very deeply by being influenced, and they're not even conscious and aware that they are completely out of balance. And what's lacking is the divine feminine energy. So much more in depth into our programs, because this is a long subject, a lot of teaching, a lot of spiritual knowledge. It's a fascinating subject, and including about the spiritual awakening with Kundalini. There are many things to bring about the divine feminine energy, and we will go over three yogic, short, very simple yogic tool that you can implement right now for yourself. And to go really more in depth with this, one needs to be in sadhana, doing spiritual practices, and eventually to start gaining a momentum with Kundalini ascension, so purification can take place. And there are many yogic practices, such as Siddha, Satchit, Kriya, Ananda. Here, it's really empowering to help balance the Ida and the Pingala, and to start feeling more in balance and to start gaining momentum with Kundalini ascension. And there is drastic way you can go to activate it, but it's not recommended. It's better that you go gently and slowly, and naturally purification takes place. You never want to force something, beloved. So three very simple. Start with Mother Earth is the embodiment of divine feminine energy. So go outside. Try this every day. You go and hurt yourself, earthing, barefoot, walk, not only walking, but bury your feet in the soil, in the ground. Really bury both of them. You could even dig out a little hole. Devi Mayi did that for many years, and you sit down and go meditate with your feet right into the earth. The iron of Mother Earth will bring about, it will help with the balance, and you're connecting with Mother Earth. Also, you could do it by the ocean, in the sand. When I'm out by the ocean, I always put my 2 feet into the sand, deep. And you could just be sitting there contemplating, self-introspect, or just meditate, or do Siddha, Satchit, Kriya, Ananda meditation. So that's one. You will notice it will rejuvenate your system. It will change your energy, because Mother Earth is divine feminine energy. Remember, those two polarity transcend gender. It's extremely important to demystify that. Now, the second one, embody the quality of Mahashakti, divine feminine energy. And everything I said apply for male as well, not just for female right now, women. Some men also are very out of balance. They have too much divine masculine. But I'm focusing more on women here, for women empowerment, because it's a big phenomenon happening on our planet right now. I see it everywhere. Women embody too much of the divine masculine energy. And it's not for their advantage, because they're out of balance. They suffer deeply. I've seen that so many, so too long. So the second yogic tool is bring out the creativity, the nurturing, the surrendering. So to do that, create a beautiful little shrine, actually an altar, let's call it an altar, not a shrine, because shrine is completely different. A place where you could have a little lamp with sesame oil, where you burned it. When you go there, you go offer yourself. You don't need anything extravagant. You could bring flowers, a fruit, sesame seed, incense, and just offer it to the divine. I call it the divine mother. For Shakti, Mahashakti, again, you understand, is a primordial divine cosmic energy. And so you just go offer it one by one, and eventually in radiating the light, you will learn the more proper way to do it in the yogic tradition. It's one aspect we cover, how to balance your divine feminine energy with your masculine energy to eventually experience the harmonic marriage of the two polarity to be in balance. So you offer it and you bow down and you surrender. You express your gratitude and your love for all the things that come, all the blessing that comes within you. You express it. And so that's the nurturing, the caring, the loving, the unconditional love. And that was the third one, but I skipped the second one. So the second one was about creativity and unleashing your imagination for the highest beauty. So tap into your creativity of, as an artist, create beauty. You can go write poetry, you could go write a book, you could write a new journal, you could write a screenplay, you could compose music. Take on the activity of learning how to chant or singing or playing an instrument or painting. Like Devi Mayi, many of you don't know, but I've been a painter for many decades in the past. And you can see some of the paintings on Devi's Grace website under creation. Oh, it was an incredible spiritual practice there. I would go into ecstasy. So you really tap into the divine feminine energy when you do that, and make the time, do it, create, feel drawn to an activity where you could really express that divine feminine energy of creativity. So those are three very simple ways you can get started right now. And write down below into the comment section which one that you feel like really is calling your soul and your spirit. And also write down which energy do you feel like dominate you more. Look back, take the time to look at your life and your quality that you embody. And subscribe and share this video if you found it valuable and insightful. Share it with your family, your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. And also check out the link below in the description on Radiating the Light. Devi Mayi offered this as a community to help you. You can come join. It's complimentary. Once a month, the last Saturday of the month, there's two different times. You can come and meditate, ask questions, and some spiritual process. It's a wonderful way to really connect. And it's always beautiful to see all of you around the world. And write down, where are you based? Where are you based? Where do you come from? So blessing on your journey, and Devi Mayi is here for you.